Now, at the end of last year, comedian Rhys Darby travelled the length and breadth of Japan, making a travel series that starts next week here on TVNZ One.
The makers hope the mix of Darby's Kiwiana japery and the randomness found in the land of the rising sun will create a perfect televisual storm of giggles, chuckles and good old-fashioned travel tips. And I can honestly report, it does.
Look out, Michael Palin. Stand aside, Joanna Lumley. F off, Phileas Fogg. There's a new name in travel films. And for Rhys Darby's first adventure, Japan has proven to be the perfect destination for New Zealand's goober god.
Rhys, how are you?
Good.
I've seen the show. Amazing show.
Thank you.
Japan is such a weird place, isn't it?
It is weird. Wonderful and weird. Suits me fine.
You start the show in pretty dramatic fashion, in a balloon, in a hot air balloon.
Mm.
And then a great line when you land where you say, the Kiwi has landed.
The Kiwi has landed.
Have you been in a balloon before? Because you look like you're quite good on a nozzle. You know how to operate a nozzle.
Well, as you know, I'm a bit of an adventurer. So I have watched a few balloon videos. And I've imagined myself in that role. So once I got in there, that was actually my first balloon. So I wanted to have that coming in as a commanding presence, a bit of the sort of passepartout, you know.
I was going to say.
Yeah.
Are you a passepartout, not Phileas Fogg?
No, that was just the first name that came to my head then when
okay.
I was thinking of Around the World in 80 Days, and passepartout, yeah, came into my head first.
Was this a step out of your comfort zone for you? You're playing yourself?
I've been myself a lot just in real life, and so I was happy with that, but I can be a bit weird myself, but I thought maybe this will be a fit, and I love travelling. Remember when we used to travel, and this is the end of it now, so this was possibly the last travel show ever made, which I love, until further notice.
Darby spent his 5 weeks in pre-COVID Japan gorging on the culture, from learning to be a samurai to having a crack at sumo. And eating and drinking all manner of disgusting local delicacies. But staying at what was billed as the world's first robotic hotel revealed the strange paradox of technology in Japan.
There is definitely humans behind the scenes that help when you really need it. Like, I can't get in the door. You know, a robot's not going to turn up. So as much as you want to be in that kind of Blade Runner futuristic mode, you're not. It feels honestly like you've gone back in time to the 70s where robots were an idea.
Of the many Japanese obsessions that Darby dabbles in, and there are many, the creation of his own mascot is a highlight of the series.
Whoa!
A perfect opportunity to mesh travel, comedy and tradition. A perfect fit for New Zealand's unofficial cultural ambassador.
I think the thing that I've come up with crosses both cultures. I mean, you look at it and you think, oh, that's definitely Japanese. But then you go, well, hang on, what is it? I did a little funny, cheeky voice, kia ora, and things like that. I'm from New Zealand, you know. So I sort of did an impression of my own voice. So now I've broken another, what do you call these things I'm breaking?
Barrier.
Barrier, and that is mascot with talk. That's a Kiwi, you know,
we're innovators.
Innovators, yeah. They said idiot, but I'm saying innovator, yeah.
Fire up the balloon! Darby's out!
It's very, very good.
Is it?
It says absolutely.
A mascot who talks, who would have thought?
I know, exactly. Breaking Barriers in Big in Japan starts next Thursday night on TVNZ1.